I'm going to show you how to write a simple shell. As discussed in class, a shell is basically a program that presents the user a prompt, and the user enters a command and parameters. The shell program will read in the command and parameters, and then it uses fork to create a child, a duplicate of itself, another shell. The child executes the command along with the parameters and then exit, while the parent, the current shell, will wait for the child to finish, and then it'll go back and present the prompt again. Now, I want to show you how to do this in C language. Okay. Suppose I call my program a shell.cpp. Now first, we need to include some headers, as shown here. And this is the main. Basically, it is the implementation of the code that I just showed you. So we need to have two arrays to hold the command and an array of pointers to hold the parameters. So note that this is an array of pointers, so that means you'll hold the parameter list. And then another array defines the environment variables. And we assume that all our commands are in the directory bin. Okay. So first, we need a function to present the prompt. We call it type prompt. And another function to read the commands and parameters. We call it read command. After that, as discussed, forked, we create a child that copy the bin directory into the array cmd, and then concatenate the command that the user has entered to the buffer cmd, and then use execve to execute the command with the parameters. And after that, if our command is exit, okay, then we break, we exit the loop. Okay, and that means we are done. Okay, so this is the main function. So next we'll see how we implement the type prompt. Okay. For a type prompt, the first time that we use it, we want to clear the screen. We can use some special ASCII NC characters to clear the screen. Here the slash E means escaped. Okay. Now, in computing, NC escaped codes or escaped sequences are a method using to control the formatting, color, and other output operations on video text terminals. To encode this formatting information, certain sequences of bytes are embedded into the text, which the terminal looks for and interprets as commands, not as character code. Now here, E11 basically means the coordinate 11, the upper left corner of the screen, and the 2 here, E2 here, means to clear the screen. Okay. So this command will clear the screen, and for the first time. And after that, we set the variable first time 0 so that it won't do it again the next time it presents prompt. Looked at first time is a static variable. Okay. So after we clear the screen, we present this prompt, the number sign. Okay. So finally, let's discuss the read command function. This is the read command function. It will return the command and parameters in these two arrays. Now basically, it'll use getC to get whatever has been entered by the user, and until a return is entered, then they exit this loop. So that means a line of characters has been entered, and we use this string TOK to break the line into tokens, which are words in our situation, and we put them in the variable array in the array. And the first word or first token we enter should be the command, so we put that in CMD, and others are parameters, and we put that in this variable PAR, and these are returned to the calling function. That's our main here, put reference parameters. So these are returned, and then it will be executed by the child. So now, suppose we compile this. Okay, and then we execute. So it presents a prompt, we execute a command, with parameters, and exit. Okay, it goes back to our original shell. Okay, so there's a simple implementation of a shell, and sure you should be able to improve upon this. Okay. Thank you, bye bye.